Well, the group is Stryper, and the music is heavy metal, but with a Christian message. Music writer John Wendeborn with The Oregonian wrote this week about this group that Christian music is coming out of the tent and into the mainstream, and it's doing that in a most unusual way with this group, Stryper. They are heavy metal. They are very popular right now, both in this country and overseas, and we are happy to welcome one of their member, in fact, their founder and drummer, this afternoon to the 2 at 4 show. Please, a warm Portland welcome, if you would, to Robert Sweets. Welcome, Robert.
Thank you.
We should point out that the other members of your group are involved in a sound check this afternoon for tonight's performance.
That's right. They're kind of busy right now, so I was the only one able to make it down.
We do appreciate your coming down.
Thank you. I'm glad to be here.
You're going to have to explain to us, forgive me for using this expression, but the Bible thumpers, if you will, have been accusing rock and roll music of being the work of the devil for a long time now, especially heavy metal music. Now, before we go much further in the conversation, how do you justify heavy metal rock and a Christian message?
It's real easy. When God tells you to do something, you go for it. I think it's better to say no to people and yes to God. Mm-hmm. Just because you paint a painting doesn't mean that all paintings are evil, but if you paint an evil painting, it's evil. Just because someone writes a book that's bad, it doesn't mean that all people who write books are evil or all books are wrong. And it's the same thing with rock music. Stryper feels and knows that rock music itself isn't bad. There's no such thing as an evil beat. A 2-4 beat in rock and roll is the same 2-4 beat that's in gospel music. A matter of fact, something that's really amazing is, did you know most hymns used to be bar tunes before they were actual put in a hymnal and the words were changed? And if that's the case, then there can be nothing wrong with the music. It's the message that goes behind the music.
The Bible admonishes Christians to not be so much part of the world, but to stay apart from the world and to try to convert it. You have the trappings of what the classic is, drug, sex, rock and roll, and what the message is there is a lot of immorality, and the whole genre of that kind of music portrays a different message. And then you come across with the trappings of this music and you have something that is totally different, and that is Christianity. How do you reconcile the two, being part of the world in such a big way?
Well, what is part of the world? I've always told people, if you've got two cars, you've got two red Mustangs, let's say for example, and you've got a Christian one and an atheist pulls up in another, is the Christian wrong because he's trying to be like part of the world? Mm-hmm. We're in this world. If you're going to go to that extreme, don't go to a doctor who's not a Christian. You know, don't buy your groceries at a store that's not owned by Christians. It's what's in your heart. And Jesus never, you know, he never said you'll know them by the way they look. It's never what's outside, it's what's inside. We're here to tell God's side of the story in rock and roll.
Okay, let's see a little bit more of the story via some more video. And correct me if I'm wrong, you began as a secular group under the name Rock's Regime. Is that correct?
You got it.
Okay. The song we're going to see is You Know What to Do. Here is Stryper.
Thank you.
radio and your albums, what are you telling people? What are you trying to tell them?
We're telling them good news, to turn on to the one that loves them. In rock and roll especially today, it's become the neat thing to hold up the devil. And the word devil means a little God. And we want to tell people, turn your lives over to the big God, the one who really cares about you and the one that loves you.
Good job.
That message will be delivered this evening at Benson High School is where Stryper is appearing in concert tonight. It's at 8 o'clock, and we're told that tickets are still available at the door. Check out Stryper. You may also do so on album. They have a 12-inch 45 called The Reason for the Season, and also a full album called Yellow and Black Attack. Our thanks this afternoon to Robert Sweet. I hope you get a good turnout at Benson High School tonight. And Godspeed. Come back and see us again.
Thank you.
Okay, Robert.
Good luck.
We'll be back with more 204.